all going to seed now.
Say hi to the camera.
Hello, Mr. Camera. How are you?
Talk worm to it.
We speak worm around here.
I thought I'd come by just for a minute. Nobody would believe. I was going to call those 10 feet tall. Perhaps they're not 10 feet tall, but
they're no puny artichokes.
I've been growing out of rocks because they'll grow in almost no soil.
Really? That's just what we need.
Well, like this.
Something that grows out of rocks.
Well, see this one here? These ones are growing legend wise.
The artichokes are what I need to feature. These artichokes are otherworldly, really.
Oh, it is
At the high point. But in the future, we're gonna have to lay it down horizontally.
Yeah, you certainly. You're as good as any artichoke.
I appreciate it.
This camera is utterly democratic.
One of the more flattering compliments I've had in a while.
It is. It was intended to be. You know, you took it rightly.
Everything I cut down survived in this growing medium.
It's a pepper plant.
It makes it really easy to store it. And you cut them down in the fall anyway, just to, because they like to be cut every year.
And you just put the whole stem back.
And you put the top, and the thing is, you have to. It's not like most plants where you cut it and then put it in the ground. You have to cut it and then wait months. You have to wait at least 2 months before you put it in the ground, or it'll rot at the bottom. So since we have to do that anyway, we cut them right before the freeze, store them over the winter, and then put them in soil in the spring after the freeze is over. That makes them real easy to keep in the house because you just put it in a jar and keep it on display in the house. And you know, with the water, it. So that's why we feel these are the plants of the future.
Yeah.
Because we go on stage 4 watering, where you're only allowed to water every 2 weeks.
Uh-huh.
That's just plenty. I don't care about anything less than
pretty neat.
2 weeks is.
That's exactly what Beth is concerned about, and why she's urging me to do water catchment and water harvesting. Exactly that. She researches it deeply.
Oh, it's going to be dry. It's going to be very, very dry.
Drier than it
was last
year.
We've had the wettest year in history, and we're still in the drought.
Yeah. We had more rain this year than we had all of last year.
All of that.
We had more rain in December than we had all of last year, which was record-breaking.
It's pretty amazing.
It's been, and you know what? What I love is all summer long, didn't all the weather forecasters, this winter's going to be warmer and drier. Warmer and drier this winter. So a lot of people go, I didn't even bother to plant a winter garden because they kept saying it was going to be dry.
That would probably generally be bad tactics not to plant a garden.
Well, it took a lot of effort to keep this one looking good.
Only somebody who was tired would not plant a garden.
We were realistic. There's a lot of stuff. It's like there's no sense planting anything because we can't afford water.
Well, I tell you what,
What I meant was there's got to be something you can plant.
Minimally, that's all I did was water.
I certainly should not be doing this.
Succulent gardens. That's what I plant.
But it was worth it.
Mint. He says what you want from mint is not so much sunshine as water, always. A drip of water on it always. The condensate from an air conditioner, for instance, always wanted. This is his aerated, where is it? This is his aerated worm tea that he makes. He can sell worms, but he gave me a pint of it. He said, mix it with 5 gallons of water. It's magnificent. Maybe you already know this. Probably you do already know this.